Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Hearthstone Singapore Major. Once again, my name is TJ, and I'm joined by Padra.
Hey, TJ, welcome back.
Oh, thank you. Wow, I wasn't expecting that. Thank you very much. What'd you think about that last game? That was a pretty intense one. The only 3-2 I think we've had so far today.
The only 3-2?
Oh. Yeah, the last game.
Well, it was a bit surprising because, like Lothar said, it was very different sort of plays, and it all worked out in the end for Shiny Pants.
Shiny Pants, that is correct. That was an interesting match. Let's talk about the next one. It is CS Joker versus ViperPro, the Singaporean player taking on the Thai player.
I think he's the only Thai player left.
Wow, okay. Well, that's big shoes for him to fill there, carrying his entire country flag.
You don't see
him.
A lot of Thai players, actually, because I know that Hearthstone just recently made the game in their language.
Yeah.
So we should see more soon.
A lot of the Southeast Asian players do speak English though also. So, but it was good to have that language support. And hopefully the scene there continues to grow. And maybe ViperPro will be the player to bring more fame and more glory to Thailand. CS Joker, though, he's sort of the hometown player for this matchup, coming in as a Singaporean player. And this is a lower bracket match. So the loser of this match is eliminated from the tournament.
Oil Rogue from CS Joker versus the mid-range Druid of ViperPro.
Yeah. And apparently ViperPro has already started off with a 2-0 lead.
Don't mind that.
Yeah.
Don't mind the flags and the... Okay, well, that's changed. I think they're changing it.
So what is this matchup? It's Rogue versus Druid. What do you think of this matchup, Hather?
I've seen Oil Rogues take on Druids fine, and I've seen Druids take on the Oil Rogue fine. It really just depends on the kind of starts they have.
Yeah. Yeah, Druids can always... Druids are Druids.
They can go with anything.
Yeah, that is a fact. Old hard fact that Druids are Druids.
Ooh, Innervate, very nice. But he's not going to use it just yet.
Yeah.
Well played.
Yeah. Didn't hit that turn 2 play, so he knows it. Alright. See, the thing about the Living Roots here is that it does so much damage against Rogue. Because a lot of times they have to use their dagger to clear it, which means... just these inner roots, living roots alone, are going to deal, 5 damage over the course of their life. So that's pretty good for a one mana spell.
Okay, we're going to see the Wrath.
Yeah. Or, Innervate the Orsand, but he doesn't really have much. Oh, wow. This
the Shredder is interesting.
Yeah, this actually becomes. Actually a tough turn now, so Wrath deals with the Shredder immediately. You can Innervate out Emperor Thorsand to put, that big threat on the board, but it's going to be answered.
There are a few options here. Innervate Emperor Thorsand or Wrath, and then Innervate Shredder.
Or just play Shredder.
Yeah, you could do that.
Yeah.
I think that's something I would just do. Just play the Shredder.
Yeah. Sort of force the Rogue to deal with it. You still want to draw more cards, I think, before you play the Emperor Thorsand, just because you're not really reducing anything worthwhile. Innervate, only gains value with Emperor Thorsand if a Lotheb is played. And Swipe and Wrath, sometimes they're good, so you can fit an extra creature in during a turn. But other than that, it's not really that useful to get them reduced.
Do we have the Sprint again? Turn 4? Deja vu?
Yeah, seriously. Yeah. Seems like this has been Rogue's go-to. I think Rogue is it undefeated today? It's close to it. Maybe it's I think there was a Malagos Rogue earlier that lost a game, but the standard Oil Rogue's doing pretty well today as far as decks go. Definitely not as rough of a time as the Murloc Paladin, which is I don't think taken a win yet.
Seems good.
Seems good. Indeed.
I was actually thinking of that play, and he was just going straight for it.
Yeah. Yeah, strong play. great way to take out the pile of Treaders. And now ViperPro next turn does have the Emperor Thorsten that he can play. Hopefully picks up maybe a combo piece or something big to that's going to get a lot of value out of the reduction.
See, this Joker has a pretty big hand, though.
Yeah.
Which is always nice for an oil rogue.
He's spending a lot of cards, but, you know, that's what rogue does.
He did clear the board, though.
Yeah, and that's the thing. You spend the cards to clear the board to gain the tempo.
Mm-hmm. I do like the Emperor here. Oh.
Hmm. Still, I think, maybe waiting for more value.
Okay.
Maybe waiting for, like, a combo piece or something that the Emperor Thorsten hitting is a little bit better than just swipes. But, ooh, this is a really strong play. The Adstrick backstab onto a piloted Shredder. Might even be able to trade. Not quite. Now, he is able to trade, but isn't able to keep his SI agent around for any longer.
Swipe hero power. Okay. No, he's going to play the MC Tech for tempo.
Yeah. I think MC Tech only really gets value in this matchup if a big Violet Teacher is made.
Exactly.
And you're most likely going to steal a 1-1, and you're probably just going to kill the rest with swipe anyway. So I like playing it as a tempo play. It makes sense. Mm-hmm. But now ViperPro is almost out of cards.
Yeah. He's going to be in trouble unless he gets a lore.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Whoa.
I was worried there for a second.
Yeah. I was like, wow, you're almost out of cards, but you're not in that bad of a spot, man.
Exactly. As soon as you just said he had no cards.
Don't do it. You're too
he
young.
He heard you.
Yeah. He just doesn't want his friends spectating his tournament matches. He's like, if I lose, I don't want to be embarrassed.
Yeah, it's probably in the rules also that you can't have spectators while in a match.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they're also not allowed to use a notepad and write down anything. It's all in their heads.
It's the same with the Hearthstone Championship Tour. The Hearthstone Championship Tour doesn't allow notes either. So sort of a lot of times the majors will model those just a nice pure Hearthstone experience. Brain power only.
Yep, no deck tracker here.
Yeah.
Do you actually use the deck tracker, though?
Well, that's a personal question.
I don't.
No, No. I don't. It distracts me more than it helps me. Digging just real deep.
So what can he do here? Do you think he's going to sprint or just Lotheb and hero power?
Yeah. Sprint, he does have one prep, I believe. No, actually, he doesn't.
He used both.
So he's used both backstabs and both preps. So what you want to have with sprint is you want to be able to play sprint and play something else. So next turn, he can pick up something that's two mana, like a Blade Flurry or like the second Eviscerate or even a Sap to be able to play that along with the sprint if that's the line of play that he's going to choose. So I really like this play. You have the initiative. Your opponent's almost out of cards. Mm-hmm. You need to push that board advantage while you have it.
Look at that. And ViperPro has all spells in his hand right now, which is pretty bad.
Yeah,
he can't seem to do anything except for Wrath and Swipe. Wrath or Swipe, really.
Yeah, he can Wrath for one to cycle on the 1-1 and then take out the Violet Teacher and just ignore the Lotheb for now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like that. He needs more options.
Yeah, that does allow a hero power to be fit in. It's pretty. It doesn't matter, really. I mean, he just goes face, but brings him closer to combo range. All of a sudden, you bring him down to 15. The reduction on the Force of Nature that you got earlier makes it so that Force of Nature Savage Orc kills. And actually, Force of Nature is down to 4 mana. He can actually Azure Drake swipe and Force of Nature in the same turn, which is 11 damage burst. From hand. All right. See what he picks up. Savage Roar would actually be lethal because of the swipe.
I like the Azure Dragon swipe here.
Yeah, Azure Dragon swipe, you float a lot of mana.
You have to hero power too.
But if you're just Ancient of Lore, then If you draw, you're susceptible to dying the next turn because there's 10 damage represented already just on board. So pretty much anything would kill you. Well, not anything, but a Tinker Sharp's Oil, an Eviscerate.
He could do Azure Drake, Swipe, and Force of Nature. Oh, yeah. This is good.
Wow, that's...
This is good.
I think that was the best pickup in his deck. Yeah. Especially if a 2-health creature or less comes out of this.
Mm.
That's probably not what he wanted to see, just because it cycles. But, you know, at least the board is clear. And he's got initiative for seemingly the first time in the game. Big Game Hunter doesn't really help.
Yeah. He's going to have to sprint here and possibly sap and just see what options he has.
Yeah. Oh, I wonder if we can zoom in on him thinking. Not quite. But yeah, sprint. Really not going to pick up into much. Sap is an option. Eviscerate would be another option if that's picked up. I still think there's one more in the deck. Yep, there's the second one. So, Azure Drake's a pretty, not a cheap cycle card, but a cheaper cycle card than Ancient of Lore. So, probably using Eviscerate's better here because you don't want to give ViperPro access to additional draws because you know that combo kills you. And getting your opponent closer to combo is not something that you can afford.
Is he going to get the Savage? Nope. Gonna draw for it.
Belcher, and there's the Savage Roar.
He's ready.
So, CS Joker has to kill ViperPro this turn, and I just don't think it's possible. Even if he picks up a Blade Flurry, that's just still not gonna be enough damage. Because that's 12 total damage with the Blade Flurry. So he's close. He's two off. And if he had Sap last turn, would he have enough mana to Eviscerate two?
Is
two,
there
three, seven? No, he wouldn't.
Is there any way out of this?
No.
A Belcher? No.
Because he'd have to deal with the Ancient of Lore also, I think, to survive, especially since the Force of Nature is four mana. He could fit into hero power.
Yeah. He's still going to try, though. Just in case he didn't have it.
Yeah.
So ViperPro is going to take the first match.
Yeah. With Druid. And Druid's just doing Druid things. But really well played by ViperPro. He found himself in some weird situations early on in the game where he was losing initiative on the board. It was looking rough for him. And he found his way into a victory.
Mm-hmm. So. Which is what the Druid always seems to do.
Yeah. Yeah. There was a couple plays there where I think CS Joker could have changed up his line of play to better increase his odds. There were some lines where he went, I want to say aggressive, but aggressively board-focused, like prepping out the Eviscerate.
You were saying that there was a turn where he was, like, using up all his spells.
Yeah, yeah. And he could have maybe held on to it a little bit more since he did have the Blade Flurry and forced his opponent. Because he used the Blade Flurry on one creature.
Oh, yeah.
So he could have been a little bit greedier, but he would have taken more damage. So his line of play is correct in his mind if your opponent draws combo quicker. But if it was a more grindy game like we saw, he might have been better off being greedy with that damage. Mm-hmm. Very well played by ViperPro. And we are going to move into game number two. ViperPro is going to throw out the Secret Paladin.
Versus the aggro druid.
Yes. And ViperPro, his face, he was very confused when he saw the Sir Finley Murgle thing. But this is, especially with the life tap, this is definitely going to give him the knowledge to him that it is going to be aggro druid or some variation of it.
I'm scared of aggro druid. They just deal so much damage really fast.
Yeah, I think most people are scared of Aggro Druid. Especially when they innervate out a Fel Reaver.
Yeah, and how is the Secret Pally going to deal with that unless they have an Ulduman?
Yeah. You feel so safe against Aggro Druid sometimes. You go into turn three and they haven't hit Wild Growth. They like Hero Power turn two. And you're like, okay, I can play this game slow. And you like Hero Power turn two also.
Mm-hmm.
And they innervate out a Fel Reaver on turn three, and you just have absolutely no way to deal with it.
Yeah,
it's one of the
really
most threatening
tough
cards in the game.
really good start for CS Joker here.
Yeah, ViperPro's got a decent curve as well, though. Mm-hmm. And
he's gonna swipe.
Yeah, so many five drops in the hand. That's not what you want to have as an aggro druid. Because you want to be able to curve out. And this gives ViperPro some really good initiative. Ooh, but he picks up pretty much dead, not dead card. It's effectively an arcane intellect in this situation.
He's gonna pick up two cards here if he divines.
Yeah, drawing right before your mysterious challenger is usually not a good idea. But he didn't really have much of a better play there except for hero powering.
Yeah.
Just because exactly this, the redemption, which is probably a one of in his deck, is just not going to be pulled from the mysterious challenger, which means he's not going to have the extra secret, and also he doesn't thin out his deck as well. But he still would have drawn it anyway, so he's not really punished in that game.
What was his other secret? So it was competitive and...
Avenge.
Okay.
He used both Noble Sacks early in the game.
Do you think he's going to innervate Dr. Boom or...
Huh.
He might Force of Nature take down the Mysterious Challenger.
Yeah. But then you're not being proactive. And as an aggro druid, it feels like you sort of need to be. But you really don't want... You don't want to trade the Druid of the Claw into the Secret Keeper, because that just feels like a really bad trade. Okay, he's going to go face. This makes sense. It is going to be punished a little bit by Competitive Spirit, but not too much.
Yeah, I like that he, made his board bigger.
Yeah.
Oh, he could... Okay, he wants a short Coghammer on the 7-7.
Yeah, CS Joker is not amused, but definitely punished for the aggressive line there. And I feel like Aggro Druid is one of the decks that's punished the most heavily. I think that's the correct way to say that. The most heavily by a lot of decks, because they have a very linear game plan. Their game plan is to play big stuff and go face. And there's so many things that punish that type of play, especially with Fellreaver. Like any type of outdoor Peacekeeper or freeze effects or Keeper of Uldumon or taunts like Belcher, since you have to attack it twice to get through it.
Mm-hmm.
Those types of things are punish Fellreaver very heavily. So it's a risky deck, I think is a good way to put it.
And little does CS Joker know, he's got... ViperPro has Tyrion, so... As soon as he takes down this big guy, Tyrion's coming out.
He's got Tyrion, and also he's got a redemption to follow up with the Tyrion. And he's already seen a Keeper, so he can pretty confidently just play this and know that it's going to stick. And CS Joker needs a really good draw off the top, and that is not the draw that he wanted. So he can play five drop, three drop here, which is pretty powerful. But it just nothing really stands up to the Tyrion. And especially with the redemption, there's no way for him to get through the Tyrion to clear off the Knife Juggler, at least not this turn. So that thing is probably going to come back.
He did have a really nice start, though. Oh, but then that was that turn where he just had, too many turn fives.
Yeah.
Too many five mana cards.
It was turn four, and he had three five drops in his hand.
Yeah.
Which is pretty brutal. So he's holding on to the flexible cards, I guess. Druid of the Claw can be used for extra burst. Wants to have the sticky creatures on the board. The double knife juggler.
He doesn't want to use the weapon before.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe a bit of an error there.
You would have liked to use the Coghammer first.
Yeah. You probably even use the Coghammer just to take out the mounted raptor. Yeah, and now these trades are really messy.
Yeah. Oh, he had to sacrifice his juggler.
Yeah. I don't even know if I like that play. He could have value traded into the lowly squire.
He's very safe right now, so he's just doesn't mind.
Yeah. All right, well, Keeper's picked up, but it's a little bit too late. And ViperPro is going to take a quick 2-0 lead in the series. And that's...
That's pretty fast games.
Yeah, if this ends up being a 3-0, that's like the 4-3 of the day. And been some quick matches.
Yeah.
What's the last deck?
It's a
Warlock.
Warlock. So it might be... It's a Zoo. Versus Zoo.
Yeah, so that's what the matchup is going to be. So this matchup's pretty volatile. You know, as is most mirror matchups. A couple cards that... But this deck from CS Joker has a dark bomb. Yeah. So it could be... There's a couple different Zoo lists that run Dark Bomb now. There's one that's like the hybrid lock. It's basically just like a mid-range...
Is that the one that runs, like, double Soulfire?
It runs double Soulfire. It runs Paladin Shredders. It runs Azure Drake, yeah.
Yeah, I've seen that.
Yeah, so that one's interesting. There's also one that's just a complete face Zoo. And it does run double Soulfire as well. And it does run double Dark Bomb as well, but it runs more aggressive cards, like Leroy Jenkins, double Arcane Golem.
He's got the power Leroy. Roaming.
Yeah. So maybe we're looking at that type of Warlock, and... You don't want to lose the board in this matchup.
Yeah, coining the Imp Gang was better than the Dark Peddler. Mm-hmm. It would have just been a free trade with the abusive sergeant.
Yeah. See if he can pick up a crucial one drop here. Abusive sergeant is fantastic.
Yeah,
Holy moly.
Wow. Just going to clear that Imp Gang really easily.
That's brutal. Implosion's not bad, because Implosion's probably the most important card in this matchup, just because not only does it build a board, but it takes away your opponent's board, which is, board is the only thing that matters in this matchup. I mean, sometimes you even trade, like, Sea Giants into 1-1s, just so, very rarely, but just so your opponent doesn't have a board, which is a crazy thing to think about. If this hits the Worgen Infiltrator.
Ooh. Yeah. It got it.
He can remove the Knife Juggler, and if he rolls a 4, he might still have a chance.
He got the 4.
And CS Joker's hand is not good, but he does pick up a Mortal Coil.
Wow, interesting. He runs a Mortal Coil also. Yeah. There's the Soulfire.
Yeah. So it looks to be that... I heard it called Hybrid Lock before, but, you know, it also could be called just Aggressive Zoo or Face Zoo, depending on what you're, like, where you draw the line. If you run Azure Drakes, if you run Piloted Shredders.
I like the Lothab here. Need a big body.
Yeah. All right, Shredder. All right, so looking more and more. And BGH? What? Okay. Fair enough.
I guess the BGHs are there for the Sea Giants.
In the mirror, yeah.
Yeah.
Dr. Boom is really, outside of, you know, the mirror matchup, is one of the only BGH targets, though. I guess in Secret Paladin, a lot of times Mysterious Challenger ends up being a BGH target also. Mm-hmm. But maybe ViperPro is... about to mount a comeback. He does have double Power Overwhelming, which with the egg, one of those Power Overwhelmings is going to get great use. But...
Oh, silences it before he could use it.
Yeah. Going to get stopped in its tracks.
I think I'd kill the egg and use the Shredder to kill the owl. Or the Shredder could just kill the Lothab.
Yeah. I like the first thing that you said. It's a value trade, but it only gets punished by more. Oh, okay.
See, because now he could just use the egg to just kill off some.
Yeah. Oh wow.
Actually, the wolf would be really handy here.
Yeah, and.
Oh, even the abusive and Bran.
Bran abusive plus the dire wolf will allow the egg to trade up.
Yeah.
I mean, this works too. And I would also like killing the Dark Peddler over the owl.
But the Bran would have been a nice body on the board.
Yeah, just in case the Dark Peddler gets healed and he did 1 damage. All right, there's the Azure Drakes. We pinpointed it correctly.
What was the card that gave it away? The Dark Bomb at
Dark
the Mulligan.
Bomb. Yeah. And then the Soulfire and the Paladin Shooter also in tandem.
Ooh, oh, wow. Perfect
That's
timing.
That's a good pickup. ViperPro just, he's like sinking further and further into his chair the longer this game goes. He does still have a lead, though. So, you know, this, even if he loses this matchup, which it looks like he's going to just because of the sheer amount of burst, CS Joker actually has 15 points of burst in his hand with spell power going into the next turn. So it doesn't look like ViperPro can find any way to survive unless he... No, there's no way to survive. Because if he taps and finds Implosion, and Implosion's for 4 on the Azure Drake, he still dies because the 13 it becomes 13 damage from hand. And
yeah,
he'd have the 2
Joker
on the board.
Yeah, CS Joker has a lot of damage.
Yeah.
He's got to do it in the right order.
That's the only thing that matters, is doing it in the right order. Or you can just go for the maximum VM and Soulfire first. But with so much on the line here, again, this is an elimination match, lower bracket match. So
ViperPro is going to try and distract him with some minions.
Yeah, but CS Joker. Yeah, Leroy Jenkins plus some burn in the hand. And that is going to be it. That's a CS Joker taking, finally putting himself on the board. He's going to make the series go 2-1, still in ViperPro's favor. But he finds a win in not quite a mirror matchup, a Warlock versus Warlock matchup, but it is the Zoo Warlock versus the more mid-range hybrid burst Warlock.
We might actually see another 3-2, close match.
It's possible. I think CS Joker still has some decent matchups left.
Yep, he still has the Aggro Druid.
Aggro Druid, I don't know if it does too well against Zoo. Because they have a lot of ways to fight against like their early stuff.
Yeah.
But we will see.
Ooh, not a good starting hand for ViperPro. Well, except for the Peddler.
And this is a decent matchup for CS Joker, the Rogue against the Zoo Warlock. It is a little bit weaker against this version of Zoo. Just because Sea Giants are really tough to deal with. Because if you sap them, a lot of times they'll just come back for, you know, even cheaper mana the next turn.
Yeah.
So you have to, like, clear the board and sap it, which is really tough to do. And also they run just a little bit more burst as well with the Leroy Jenkins. It's easier to combo with Power Overwhelming because you don't have to risk discarding Power Overwhelming like with Doom Guards. Flame Imp's good, but it gets pretty heavily punished by Blade Flurry at some point in the near future.
It's tough.
Soulfire just provides additional burst.
Yeah.
Do you like the burst plan, or do you like the board plan?
I like the Soulfire.
Just to be able to close out the game more quickly.
Yeah, and deal with hard things like Violet Teacher, maybe. I haven't seen a Tomb Pillager in a while.
There was Tomb Pillagers in one of the games earlier. One player, I just can't remember off the top of my head right now, ran Malagos Rogue. And he had double Tomb Pillager. He was able to get the coins and start a big draw train with the Gadget and Auctioneer, but ended up losing that game because it was a little too late. Ooh, Power Overwhelming allows ViperPro to deal with the SI agent. But is it worth it? Answer is no, at least a ViperPro.
Really scary for ViperPro right now. There's a Blade Flurry, Fan of Knives.
Yeah. Blade Flurry is such an important tool in this matchup. You want to try and save it until your opponent, you know, overextends.
Yep.
He could probably just get away with using a Phantom Knives here, maybe even holding on to his dagger, depending on what he picks up. Also, there's merit in holding on to the Phantom Knives, just because next turn you have Azure Drake Prep Fan, which is also really powerful. All right, so going to use the Blade Flurry now. And I think the only reason why he's expending this early is because of that Azure Drake prep Phantom Knives play, which is super strong against most Zoo boards. And now ViperPro is just sort of throwing stuff out there. He's got such an awkward hand. He's got a lot of burst, but that's about it.
He needs minions for the power overwhelming.
Yeah. And it doesn't look like Sea Giant's gonna find a home.
Oh no.
Bran is very threatening, so not surprised to see a. Oh, okay. This is clever. I like that. Maximum use of the mana from preparation, and also clears the board. Oh my gosh, this is just so.
It's hard. He's not getting. Oh.
All right. This is one of those situations where you make a mistake and you cover up the mistake by changing your game plan. He didn't play the Knife Juggler first, so instead of giving up to his opponent that he was going to play the Knife Juggler, he just said, you know, I'm just not going to play it.
Yeah.
There we go. I'm sure everybody's done this really, many times.
It really did look like he wanted to play the Knife Juggler.
Yeah, and then he realized that he played it in the wrong sequence, so instead of revealing to his opponent that he...
Well, it was most likely dead. The next turn.
True, but still, it's just the, I don't know. Maybe he, I'm not gonna even try and justify. This is not that great of a hand for CS Joker. He's got a lot of spells that are very situational. Sap is not useful right now. Blade Flurry with a single creature on the board also is not useful. He can start throwing eviscerates at the face.
Can he hit with his weapon? Or did he hit already?
You can hit with this weapon, yeah.
Oh, there we go.
And just weapon up, I mean. Oh, and actually deadly poison. So I think this sets up for lethal next turn.
Mm-hmm.
Blade Flurry would be 4 with the double eviscerates with spell power on the board would be an extra 10. So that'd be 14. So,
yeah. Is that 17 damage next turn?
It's even more than that, I think.
Oh, yeah, with the Blade Flurry.
And with the deadly poison hit. So it's 7 plus 10, 17 plus the 4 on board. It'd be 21 if nothing's cleared. Or if he doesn't play Defender of Argus. I'd imagine he just played Defender of Argus. But I still think this is... Yeah, still lethal. He can even just sap it if he wants to.
Oh, it's going to be a 2-2.
Yeah. And we sort of called this the CS Joker's deck lineup.
All the games are pretty... It's like they're really close, or it's just like 3-0.
Yeah. That's true. That's very true. And I think a lot of that has to do with the lineups. Some lineups match up well against others. And so we're going to... The last match is going to come down to... Aggro Druid versus Zoo Warlock. Which is a pretty exciting match.
Yeah, I'd say 50-50, really. So ViperPro did have the 2-point lead, and now it's like down to the line.
It's slipping away from him slowly.
Yep.
So now it's pretty much all erased, and this match has all of a sudden become a best of one. And that's a pretty good hand.
He needs, not for ViperPro, he doesn't want his power overwhelming.
Not for ViperPro, no, I'm looking at CS Joker. Yep. He's got Sir Finley turn one. Then he's got Coin Innervate Druid of the Claw on turn two. And then Mounted Raptor on turn three.
Oh, that's why ViperPro is sort of fail fishing.
Yeah.
That was his final mulligan.
Yeah, not like this. And the CS Joker knows. If you get a strong creature's out early, whoa! Insta chose.
Ouch.
The steady shot.
That's gotta hurt, especially if your hand is like not the greatest.
Yeah. ViperPro deciding what emote to go with.
He doesn't even.
He's like, okay, a threat and it's good for the situation.
CS Joker looks happy.
Yeah, I'd say so. Coin, innervate, druid of the claw. Charge it. Yep.
Oh.
Oh.
He even makes the trade.
Yeah.
Because, you know, he doesn't want any minions for ViperPro on the board.
Yeah. I mean, a Power Overwhelming would trade up perfectly
mm-hmm.
with the Taunted Up Druid of the Claw. So this way he's getting more value out of the cat form. And you know what? ViperPro can still fight back onto this board. There's going to be a lot of creatures. Sea Giant can come out. Defender of Argus is a decent pickup.
I like that. Can trade nicely with the cat, and the zombie chow can go into the whichever. Finley or the raptor. I would pick the Finley, so you don't have to deal with, like, another minion right now.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let him break the raptor himself.
True. Both plays are a little bit vulnerable to swipe, but there's absolutely no way that you can, you know, play around on the mess. This actually plays around it. Not more, but pretty much the same. Either way, it'd be a board clear. This way, he can just ignore and push face damage. That's exactly what he's doing. He's got the steady shot, so ViperPro's on the clock.
Oh, that's a nice one drop.
Yeah. Okay. I was going to say, Imp King boss...
It's like, near the end, as a zoo against an aggro druid, you're like, do I want to tap anymore? It's like, what if they have combo and you're just dead?
Near the end?
Yeah.
On turn 5?
Oh, okay, yeah.
Turn 5, I guess, is near the end of this matchup. Yeah.
It's scary.
Yeah.
Okay, well, Lothip helps.
And, you know, csjoker1123 is starting to run out of steam just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So, he does have, you know, he's sort of diversifying his assets here on the board. So, making it really hard for Zoo to clear. Especially with just one big creature. He's only going to be able to clear once a board. So, even just 2 damage a turn taking in, or 4 damage a turn if you count the mm-hmm. hero power, the steady shot.
I like the creepers and the sea giant here. And the Lothib has to trade into the juggler.
Is this going to be enough to fight back on the board? I don't know. He's going to be taking so much damage. At least 4 next turn from the Keepers of the Grove. 6 if you count the hero power. And all of a sudden that puts him on a really short clock. And you factor in Dr. Boom to that equation. And all of a sudden you're looking at a lot of damage
mm-hmm.
with Boombots. That will probably go to the face. Pickup here is okay. No burst damage.
ViperPro didn't like that.
I don't like it either when my opponent plays Dr. Boom. I don't blame him.
Okay, what can he do here? I'm so full.
He's just thinking of whether or not he wants to trade into the Lothib. If he doesn't trade into Lothib, how much damage is that from hand? 13, 14 plus. 14 from Leroy, power overwhelming, power overwhelming. So he'd be 2 damage off lethal.
What?
Yeah, that's pretty crazy. Actually, no, those are both natural power overwhelmings. Neither of those power overwhelmings came from a dark peddler, right?
Yeah, they didn't.
Yeah. I was going to say, if he had gotten one from a dark peddler early and picked up the 3rd power overwhelming, that would have been the ultimate punish. But puts him at 10. Very scary situation to be in. If you're ViperPro.
You know what? If he had 1 extra mana, he would have had lethal.
Yeah, with the Direwolf Alpha, it would have been exact.
Yeah, exactly.
Exacties. It actually would have been 1 over, because you could have gotten the value from the Direwolf Alpha on 2 creatures, and then placed the charge down. So it actually would have been 31 damage if he had 1 more mana. If only Warlocks had access to Wild Growth. Imagine if every class had access to Wild Growth. Imagine if Wild Growth was a common spell. Or a neutral spell.
I'm trying to think, what is the best thing he can do here? Is there a comeback? Is he gonna go face?
That direwolf's looking awfully lonely over there on the left. Yeah.
He wasn't quite sure about that, but he did get the force of nature.
Right.
Came
off
back
the top.
From pretty much 0-2.
Yeah.
Took three wins.
Exactly 0-2. Yeah, and ViperPro has to be pretty upset about that one. But well played by CS Joker, and you know,
that was a crazy comeback.
Yeah. And you know, you could say he has a lineup that's built towards beating the Zoo Warlock, and that's why he 3-0'd with it. So that means ViperPro is unfortunately eliminated from the tournament, and CS Joker will survive to compete another day. He will move on to the matches tomorrow.
Some good games.
Yeah. We got to see that sort of mid-range hybrid Warlock in action, which is a sort of fun deck to watch. It's got a lot of burst potential.
Yeah, that was fun. I like that. I haven't tried that myself yet.
Yeah. I've tried it a few times. I was climbing with it at the beginning of, was it this season? Oh, man, it feels so long ago. Yeah. That's the deck that I've been doing my Warlock quests with so far this season. So it's really fun. It does tend to have some pretty poor draws. But so does Zoo Warlock. If you get like the Soul Fires and the Power of Warmings in your opening hand, mm-hmm. if you get your Burst in your opening hand, that's not what you want. So, yeah. That was really well played by CS Joker.
Yeah.
And that's going to do it for that series, though. We do have one more series, I believe, for the day. It is going to be another lower bracket matchup. And it's going to be Corneco versus TCG. So that's going to be a fun one. But we are going to go to a quick break before we jump into that match. Last match of the day. So don't go anywhere, guys. More Hearthstone Singapore Major card slinging action continues right after this.